The RC2014 Mini comes with 32 kilobytes of memory. However, the moment that you power down the computer, anything in memory will disappear. Obviously, you will want to keep any code you write safe for the next programming session. While you can buy storage solutions for the computer, which we will be covering in later videos, what we will be covering today is how to easily save and manage your assembly code. As seen in the last video, here we are in the TerraTerm application and connected to the RC2014 via a USB cable. Having displayed the memory at 8000 hex and filled it with zero values, we are now ready to put some assembly code in place. In the last video, we used the edit memory command in this monitor to enter some machine code. Today we are going to use a website to help us use Z80 assembly. This website is asm80.com, which is free to use. The first thing to do is to click on the New File option. Here you can select what type of CPU we're going to be putting assembly in for. We're picking Z80 here, and we're giving our file a file name. This will create a file which you'll see up in the workspaces. This is purely local to your browser. Having created your workspace file, you can then either start typing your assembly commands into the window or just paste in code that you've prepared in Notepad on your computer. Saving your source in Notepad files allows you to safely store even very large assembly listings on your own Windows computer. Here we now have an assembly listing pasted in, and the website nicely color codes the commands and their parameters, also allowing you to put in labels for the subroutines. Then just click on the compile button to both check your syntax and create a hex file. Should there be any syntax errors, they will be highlighted on screen. Clicking on the hex file will display it, allowing you to select the data onto your clipboard. Next, switch back to TerraTerm and simply paste into it. In our assembly listing, the first command was to set the origin of the code, which is the location it inserts the hex. Now if we have a look at the data at the 8000 hex level, we can see our code has now arrived. And if we use the disassemble command to actually display this on screen, we can see there are all the calls and the loading of the accumulator, which if we compare this back to what we've got on the website, right at the beginning of the code, we will see there is all the code we've put in. It has changed all the hex calls to their actual locations based on where the label was, and at the end of each of the subroutines there is a return command. So what we've achieved today is we have taken source code in assembler, which we have saved in Notepad files, and we have pushed this through the asm80.com website to compile our code down to hex and then use the cut and paste to paste it straight in to our RC2014. Hopefully you'll find these facilities useful. That's it for today. Thank you for watching.